Dear friends, welcome to this podcast on dermoscopy of basal squamous carcinoma. As you probably know, basal squamous carcinoma is a synonym term to the previous term metatypical basal cell carcinoma or even metaplastic basal cell carcinoma. So traditionally, this tumor has been considered as a subtype, an histopathologic subtype of basal cell carcinoma. However, during the last decades, a new hypothesis has been proposed, and this hypothesis is that, in fact, basal squamous carcinoma is an intermediate tumor between basal and squamous cell carcinoma. So it's a mixed tumor that consists of components of BCC and SCC histopathologically, first of all, and this is true. In basal squamous carcinoma, histopathologically, we can find foci of basal cell carcinoma, foci of squamous cell carcinoma, but also a transition zone in between. And in terms of biology, again, retrospective studies have shown that basal squamous carcinoma behaves in a much more aggressive manner as compared to other BCC subtypes in terms of recurrency rates, but also in terms of metastasis rates. Of course, these observations have not up to date been confirmed by further studies, and those that still believe that basal squamous carcinoma is a BCC subtype criticize the previous studies, saying that those metastatic basal squamous carcinoma, in fact, might have been just squamous cell carcinomas which were underdiagnosed. Anyway, while this controversy on the true biology of the tumor continues, let's speak for a moment on the morphology of basal squamous carcinoma. So how does it look like from a morphologic point of view? And first of all, clinically, basal squamous carcinoma is usually a keratotic nodule. This is a typical basal squamous carcinoma. Of course, in earlier stages, it's possible that the tumor is not yet so advanced, so we don't see a large nodule, but we see only a small papule, and then even a hyperkeratosis is not so evident. And also the opposite, in more advanced stages, basal squamous carcinoma can become quite impressive from a morphologic point of view, invading large parts of the surrounding skin, like in this case. In terms of dermoscopy, our knowledge is mainly based on this multicentric study that was published a few years ago. And according to this study, the dermatoscopic findings of basal squamous carcinoma are quite reasonable, meaning that the main pattern is a combination of BCC features and SCC features in the same tumor. So it seems that dermoscopy mirrors the peculiar histopathology of the tumor. Of course, I will not go now through analytically through the main structures of BCC and SCC. I would just like to remind you that in BCC we have mainly vascular structures and also pigmented ones, while in squamous cell carcinoma the main clues are white colored, like keratin structureless areas, circles surrounding follicles, or halos surrounding vascular structures. So most of these features can be also seen in basal squamous carcinoma, but remember that the clue is that we find simultaneously in the same tumor at least one BCC-like feature plus one SCC-like feature. And now let's see a couple of examples. First of all, clinically, this is a nodule on the nose, and this is dermoscopy of this basal squamous carcinoma. If we spend a little bit attention on the dermatoscopic image, we can see that, first of all, there are vessels, and the vessels are linear and somehow arborizing, branching. So this is a BCC clue. At the same time, we can also find at least one blue globule or blue dot, which again is a basal cell carcinoma clue. But in the upper part of the tumor, in these circles, you can see follicles surrounded by white color, so white circles surrounding follicles, which is considered a classic clue of squamous cell carcinoma. So BCC features plus SCC features. One more example, a hyperkeratotic elevated lesion, not really nodular, but elevated. And here is dermoscopy. Again, we can see that there are blood crusts, so blood in keratin, which is theoretically a clue for squamous cell carcinoma. And also, within this circle, there are vessels surrounded by white color, surrounded by white halos. Again, a clue for squamous cell carcinoma. But on the upper part of the lesion, there are completely different vessels, linear ones, somehow branching. So a clue for basal cell carcinoma. So again, combination of SCC clues plus BCC clues. One more example, a flat hyperkeratotic lesion on the forearm. This is dermoscopy. Again, in the center, we can see blood in keratin, those black structures, and also, which is a clue for squamous cell carcinoma. Also, hyperkeratosis, quite intensive, again, a clue for squamous cell carcinoma. But on the left part of the lesion, we can see some vessels, which again are linear and somehow branching, which might be a clue for BCC. And also at the periphery, we can see these bluish, grayish globules or nests, which again is a clue for BCC. So BCC clues plus SCC clues in the same tumor. One more example, clinically and dermatoscopically. So dermatoscopically, we can see hyperkeratosis, which is rather a clue for squamous cell carcinoma. Maybe also on the upper part, some white follicles, which again is a clue for squamous cell carcinoma. But at the periphery, again, there are these bluish, grayish globules, which represent a clue for basal cell, and also on the upper part, these brownish peripheral structures remind a little bit the leaf-like areas of basal cell carcinoma. So again, a combination of BCC clues plus SCC clues. And finally, three images in the same slide, a BCC, an SCC, and the basosquamous carcinoma. Which is which? Can you tell them apart? Well, the basal cell carcinoma is the one on your left. We can clearly see arborizing vessels and also blue gray globules or dots, both of them clues for basal cell carcinoma. The squamous cell carcinoma is the one on your right. We can see vessels surrounded by halos, and also on the upper part of the tumor we can see follicles surrounded by white circles. So both of them clues for squamous cell carcinoma, and of course also blood crusts in keratin, again clue for squamous cell carcinoma. And finally, in the middle, you can see one more basal squamous carcinoma, and here we can find clues for SCC, for example, blood in keratin, and also in the lower part, white circles surrounding follicles, so clues for SCC. But on the upper part, upper right, we can find vessels, linear vessels, and somehow arborizing, which represents a clue for basal cell carcinoma. So this is the concept that basosquamous carcinoma dermatoscopically displays at least one BCC feature plus at least one SCC feature. And thank you so much for watching this podcast.